This is Adjuster TV, Adjusters First.
This video is sponsored by AdjusterPro. Use code AdjusterTV at checkout and get licensed right now at adjustertv.com/licensing. How much can you make as an adjuster? So we talked a little bit about like how adjusters are paid. Now we're going to talk about how much you can make, okay? And it's not really as simple as saying, well, you know, so-and-so's fee schedule is this, and it's better than this fee schedule over here, or this IA firm splits, gives you a 70%, it's like 70-30 split, and then this one over here only does 55-45. It's not that simple, okay? We want to take a look at, first of all, what the average per claim is that you can make, right? So in other words, if you're an independent adjuster and you're making money running claims, especially catastrophe claims where you're basically working on a fee schedule, as we talked about previously, we're going to talk about what the average is. What can you make on average? So generally speaking, you can earn on the low end for doing full claims, maybe $120 per claim. And that's for scoping the loss, making the contacts, making a coverage decision, writing an estimate, settling up with the homeowner, right, on the low end. And a million different factors come into play with this, right? So on the high end, you can make $900, $1,200 plus, and a lot higher, right? So you could go on a storm where you average, you know, $2,000 per claim, right? But those are probably going to be pretty big claims, maybe possibly even total losses, if that's what your average is. And again, remember that when you go on a storm, you're going to have a lot of smaller losses, and then you're going to have some, you know, fewer medium-sized losses, and then if you have any bigger losses, there'll be a very small percentage of those, right? So we're talking about the average over the course of a storm, right? The problem is that because you can't choose, I mean, you can technically choose, like if you go on a storm or you don't go on a storm, but if you get called and you're like, I need to go to work, or I want to go to work, which is need and want, basically it doesn't matter, go, right? And they say, hey, go to wherever, and you go, you can't be like, oh, by the way, only give me claims that are going to be high billers. You absolutely cannot do that. They're just going to give you what they got. And it's your job to show up and take care of them, no matter if they're $120 a piece or if they're $1,200 a piece, right? That's why you're hired, is to close claims, not to demand higher pay, right, or higher money, because that part's really up to you. And I'm going to kind of break this down and kind of end us up back to where how much you make in a year depends on you working through factors that you can't control, right? If that makes sense. So I would say that the average that a typical cat property adjuster can earn, and this is independent of tax and expenses, is maybe right around $300 to $400 per claim. Oh, if you average everything out over the course of a typical year for a cat property adjuster, going out doing windstorms, hailstorms, water claims, maybe a wildfire, maybe a hurricane, something like that, right? And as far as taxes go, that's an individual thing. That's between you and your CPA and perhaps your priest. As far as expenses go, again, those are pretty variable, and they can vary depending on where you get sent, as well as how you spend your money, right? So it's really kind of up to you. And on top of that, I hear people, you know, I talk about this sometimes, and I get the comments, you know, well, you know, you're not taking into account the expenses and da-da-da, so it makes it not worth it. That's totally not true, right? If you make $100,000 a year, if you gross the revenue $100,000 and, you know, $18,000 of that is your expenses, right? And then you take some tax, then you're gonna adjust your gross income, which will be, that you wanna have those expenses to adjust that gross income. It puts you in a lower tax bracket, right? You're still gonna come away pretty good, right? And you can still control, you know, you have some control over how much more money that you can make. And if you went out for every single day of the year, right? If you were out 365 days, that's all you're gonna spend on expenses, right? So expenses cap, right? So you can if you're efficient and you get good at this, you can do more claims. Your expenses are going to stay down here. The expenses don't increase with the more claims and more money you do beyond a certain point, right? Obviously, the second you jump in your car to drive far enough away where you have to get a hotel, then you know, as long as you're there, you're paying a hotel expense. But there's only so much of that, right? It's not an infinite number that scales up with your earnings, right? Because if you can close more claims, if you can close twice as many claims a day as I do, then you're going to make more. We're going to have the exact same expense. It's the bottom line. It's my point, right? So if you run the math out and you say, all right, well, I want to, you know, make $100,000, right? Then $300 out of $100,000 is what? Right, or $100,000 divided by 300. You have to do 333 claims in a year, right, at $300 a piece, right? Taxes and expenses, that's on you to figure out and to optimize on your own, you know, according to the law and according to your tolerance for whether you want to stay in a nice hotel or okay hotel or sleep in your car, please don't do that, but whatever, right? So if you worked for 6 months, then 333, which is 180 days. So we could say you're not going to be in the field closing claims every single one of those days. So maybe you're doing 150 days, right? So 150, let's see, what is that? It's two claims a day. Sorry, I'm so used to using a calculator, I can't run this kind of math in my head because I'm just not that smart, right? I use tools for these kinds of things, and I recommend that you do as well. So that's 2.2 claims a day. We'll round it up to three claims a day, right? Three closed claims a day through storm season, right? Even the most average sort of mediocre adjuster should be able to close three claims a day, right? So doing this math, using these numbers, you could generate gross revenue in a year of $100,000, working 6 months, close, and not really worrying about like how many months or days that you work, but just trying to hit 300 to 400 closed claims in a year, right? Obviously, that's a pretty easy number to hit. As a cat property adjuster, I try to close at the minimum, the absolute floor that I wanted to close every day that I was able to close claims was 6, right? So I did pretty well as an adjuster. The averages were all over the place, right? But I didn't care because I was more interested in a volume of claims because that volume was going to translate into a higher overall revenue by the end of the year. So how do you get that volume, right? There's only so many storms. There's only going to be so many claims in a year. You're competing with other adjusters, right? So how do you put yourself in a position where you can get more claims closed in a year so that you can make more money, right? And just to take one step sideways on this, because I only care about the volume of claims that I close, I'm not going to fight and argue and wheel and deal and negotiate up to a certain point. There's a point beyond which that you absolutely want to do this. But in the beginning, particularly, you don't have a leg to stand on. You're not going to negotiate fee schedules. You can't negotiate fee schedules at all. You can try to negotiate the split with the IA firm. I recommend that you don't try to do that, especially in the beginning. If you're untested, nobody knows who you are, why should they give you more money, right? I'm going to probably also not sit there and be like, if they call me and want to send me someplace and it's for a carrier that I know doesn't have a super high fee schedule, I'm not going to turn that work down because I'm waiting for, you know, a better gig to come along where I can be like, so who's this for? Oh, it's for this company and they have a really good fee schedule. I'm going with them. I'm so glad I sat around here on my butt for 9 weeks and waited for this thing to show up and I missed three other storms. I'm not going to do that because I want to close as many claims as possible. It's kind of like if you're into investing at all, a concept called dollar cost averaging, right? You just take every claim that they give you. There's going to be big ones. There's going to be little ones. We only care about that number and that average, right? So how do you close a higher average of claims? Well, you have to close more claims on with every opportunity that you get to work claims, right? So in other words, if you an opportunity being a storm, right? So if you're, and I speak obviously from the cat property adjuster perspective, get sent to a hailstorm in St. Louis, you know, everybody gets 40 claims to start. I want to try to close at least 150 claims on that storm, maybe 200 claims plus, right? The way I'm going to do that is by being more efficient, closing more claims, having a better quality claim, and a better customer experience on the claims that I handle, right? And the number one metric there, of course, being the, well, number one of the top three, which are very close to each other, is that volume piece, right? And that's the piece that's going to get more money into my pocket, is the volume piece. Because not only will I make more money per day, which will shrink my expenses, right, because I'm doing more work in less time, but my managers, carrier manager and my IFR manager, are going to notice that, right? They're going to be like, Matt's knocking it out of the park. We just got another bunch of claims in from this side of town, or we had an adjuster had to leave because they had a family emergency. Pile all those claims on Matt because he's closing claims, right? That's how you get to 150 claims or 250 claims out of a hailstorm instead of doing 40 or 60, right? Or, you know, taking your 40 and, well, I guess that's it. We're done. Bye and see ya. If you did two claims a day and it took you however long that is, right? 3 weeks to do 40 claims. You want to knock out 40 claims in a week or less, right? That's how you get more claims on one storm. They've got to be good claims, right? They can't be run and gun, garbage claims, it's going as fast as possible because Matt said volume is the answer. Volume is not the answer. Volume is how you make money, but you can't get, you know, you can't get to the next storm or get, you know, to that big number if you don't have a high quality claim product, if you're not doing the absolute best job that you can. Your speed will be limited by how quickly you can close a claim claims in a day while not losing quality. That's my rule, okay? So think about it in terms of if I were to go any faster than this, then my quality would start to degrade, my performance review numbers would start to degrade, and the carrier may not be as interested in hiring me as they would if I was cruising along at a steady 4 to 5 claims a day and they were really, really great claims, right? And I could occasionally bump up 6 to 7 and then pop back down to 4 or 5, right? Instead of being like 7, 8, 9, but they're just terrible claims and everybody's upset and everybody's phone's ringing because the homeowners are mad, right? You don't want to be that adjuster. We don't want run and gun adjusters. We don't want mercenaries, right? I've said this before. So the key to volume is closing more claims during the day, and that limit, you know, is kind of like set up by the highest quality claim that you can do, how many of those can you do in a day, right? And then they'll start pouring more claims to you. So you're closing more claims on a storm, right? They like you, right? They know your work and they trust that you're gonna do a great job. You have good numbers, right? They're gonna try to keep you busy. So the next thing that comes up, hey, we got something in Des Moines. Hey, we got something in Pueblo. We got something in, you know, Albuquerque. We got something in Miami. Whatever it is, I'll be there, right? Just tell me, give me the address and I'm on my way, out the door, right? Then you're gonna get more claims and you're gonna do the exact same thing, right? And you keep doing it, you do that as much as you can. More opportunities pop open for you, the better you do at this. And you got to hit all three of those metrics, right? You got to hit the volume metric, the volume can't be at the expense of the quality of the file and the user experience, the customer experience, right? Your customer service. If you're rude to the customer or you're short with them or you don't call them back because you're too busy, you know, I'm, you know, closing a bunch of claims, I don't feel them, I'm knocking them out of the park. If you're not calling the homeowner back, you're not knocking them out of the park. You're gonna get your butt kicked, right? Because everybody else's butts are getting kicked because of messes that you're making, and the feet are gonna start swinging towards you pretty quick. So high volume, or as high volume as you can with the highest quality of file, meaning like you're not missing damage. You got a really, really nice looking file. It's clear, it's easy to read, it's complete, right? It's got everything in it that needs to be there. And the customer felt like that they got a fair shake and they were taken care of and it was the right experience, right? You didn't go over the top, you know, kissing rear ends and all that kind of stuff. And you didn't, you know, just totally neglect the customer. You gave them a really solid experience that the carrier wants you to have so that they can maintain that relationship between themselves and their customer, right? So that is the key to making a lot of money as an insurance adjuster. It's forgetting about the split, it's forgetting about the fee schedules, it's forgetting about all that stuff and just getting out there and doing the highest quality possible file that you can, as many of them as you can close. One last thing I'll mention with regard to fee schedules, because there's going to be some people, I see it typing down there in the comments already. Well, you know, I mean, so-and-so, they've got a terrible fee schedule and blah, blah, blah. You should absolutely go for the highest fee. Do whatever you want to do, right? This is just information for you to take and use, do with as you will. But with 20 years of experience, I can tell you right now, a lot of times the company that has kind of an fee schedule also has a really easy process that I'm not expecting a whole lot from you at this rate, right? So I might be able to easily close an average of 6 claims. When I say these numbers, I'm talking about wind and hail, right? Primarily, because it's primarily what you're going to do as a cat property adjuster. 6 claims a day, 7 claims a day, maybe have like a really long day and I get out there early and the stars line up and I can do 8 or 9, right? Easily. Not a whole lot of compliance, not a whole lot of rigmarole, right? I only have to get into Xactimate and I can do the whole claim in there and it buttons itself right up and I go on to the next one, right? And it's the fee schedules, meh. It's not great. It's not the best ever. Wish it was better, but it's okay, right? And then I got a really, really great fee schedule over here, but it's for some company with a vast bureaucracy that everybody wants to gather some data from the claims. Well, you know, the adjuster's going to be at the house. We might as well have him look at this and take pictures of that and check this box and fill out this form and da da. And you've got like 50 things to do on one claim just to get it closed. And that's beyond writing the estimate, you know, taking photos and labeling them and doing the activity diary and a claim summary and your invoice. There's 50 more things on top of that, right? And it takes you, even at your fastest, most efficient, you're closing 3 and 4, maybe 5, like, and you're struggling to do that because, well, but I'm making more money on this one, but you're struggling to close a decent volume of claims. I'm probably gonna make more money than you over here with less stress, being able to sleep all night, not having to stay up until 1 o'clock in the morning, checking boxes and doing all of the rigmarole garbage that this company wants you to do. I'm knocking it out of the park over here and it's easier, right? The work is easier and I can make more money because I can do more work, right? There's a saying out there, you probably heard it, you know, work smarter, work smarter, not harder, right? I don't like that because I like to work and I like to work hard and I like to be productive when I do work. So I say work smarter so that you can work harder. And what I mean by that is that really, really analyze your workflow, be smart about how you do your claims, how you build efficiencies, and that will allow you to apply like your engine of like hard work and get more done with that, right? So you can go farther, you can go faster in this, you know, having a more efficient process, right? So you're being smarter about it so that you can get more done, right? That's how I feel about it. But that's a really good question. I get it. I get this question all the time.
Did you know that this is just a clip of a much longer video? To watch the whole show and for a chance to have your questions answered by me, become a member at AdjusterTVPlus.com.